Welcome to the Kevin Dunn Show, and as always, we're so excited that you've taken the time out to join us. Hope you are having a wonderful day. Another special show on top for you today. We have a five-star high school football recruit, Terry Godwin, who's committed to the University of Georgia. When we come back from the commercial break, we're going to be introducing to you Terry Godwin.
At Charter Bank, you get totally free checking with online statements. You betcha. Free mobile banking, free online banking, free online bill pay, free debit card, even a new account gift. Free. At Charter Bank, we're here to wow you. And totally free checking is just the beginning. Come see us or open online at charterbank.net. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
This report just came into our news desk and it reads, America's Mattress is moving on up. That's right, you heard it. America's Mattress is moving on up to a new location, and they are having a big moving sale. Due to our high volume, we are moving to a larger location. All Perfect Sleepers have been reduced. Dream Haven Lion Headboards reduced. iComfort and iSeries floor models are sale priced with or without adjustable bases. We had rather sell them than move them. You don't want to miss our big moving sale at America's Mattress. Welcome back to the Kevin Dunn Show. Terry Godwin is in the house. Five-star high school football recruit, man. How you doing?
Good, how about you?
A five-star recruit. And you were just telling me backstage that you are one of the top five high school recruits in the country. That's true?
Yes, sir.
And the number one in the state of Georgia?
Yes, sir.
Man, tell us about when you first started playing sports. Was that something you wanted to do, or that was something that your parents wanted you to do?
I mean, we all wanted to do it because we grew up watching sports, and just our life evolves around sports. It's just something my family does.
Okay. And what was the first sport that you signed up to play?
From my memory, I would say between football and baseball.
Football and baseball?
Yes, sir.
And do you remember how old you were when you first started playing?
I would say 5 or 6.
5 or 6.
Yes, sir.
Now, which one do you like the most?
Oh, I love them both. It's a competition between both.
It's a competition between both?
Yes, sir.
What do you think you're better at? I know you're good at both of them, but which one do you think you're better at?
Most people say I'm better at football than baseball, but I really think baseball.
Baseball?
Yes, sir.
Wow, and so there's a potential possibility that you can be high up on that baseball list as well. And now, so you have brothers and sisters?
Yes, sir.
Do they play sports as well?
My oldest, she doesn't, but the second oldest, she plays basketball at the University of Georgia.
Oh, so she plays at the University of Georgia?
Yes, sir.
And what's the classification, freshman, sophomore?
She's a redshirt junior this year.
Okay, redshirt junior.
Yes, sir.
So she was pretty good in basketball in high school.
Yes, sir.
And I hear your dad was very athletic as well.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay, all right. So what age did you, if you can remember, what age did you really know that you were a little further advanced in athletics than most kids?
I would say between 7 to 11 years old.
And so when you first noticed that, what were your thoughts? Did you know you were good, or you just knew you were better than most of the people that you were playing with?
At that time, I just knew I had more talent and just a little more maturity at my age level. Mm-hmm. So I played up in recreation. So I just followed my heart.
So you played up in recreation?
Yes, sir.
When you say played up, so you're saying like when you were 9, you played in the 10 and 11 age group?
Yes, sir.
Wow, that's incredible, man. So you play football, you play baseball, you play basketball.
Yes,
and
sir.
You're good at all three of those sports. Are there any sports later on in life that you would like to try?
I would probably say soccer.
Soccer?
Yes, sir.
And what is no golf?
No, sir.
No golf.
I don't have the patience for golf.
So why do you say that?
Because golf is really a quiet game.
Uh-huh.
I like to move and just be on the move. And
mm-hmm.
I like the excitement.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. So now, how did you become noticed? Okay, you know, being one of the top five recruits in the nation. I mean, how did this process even start? Where did you first start getting noticed?
My eighth grade year,
mm-hmm.
it was like going into my ninth grade. It was spring training at the high school.
Mm-hmm.
We had a little competition, big man on campus. So mm-hmm. you call somebody out and you just go head to head. So we had a lot of college scouts there from the seniors and juniors that was there.
Mm-hmm.
So one coach from Alabama, he told me, "Here's my card. You're gonna be great one day. Just stay in touch with me."
Mm-hmm.
And it shocked me because mm-hmm. I never thought that happened that early.
In the eighth grade.
Yes, sir.
And a coach from Alabama.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. Well, we won't talk about that. But anyway, so what happened next after the eighth grade year? I think I'm going to go into that a little bit more later on. But I want to know about as far as do you feel that you are a good leader right now? Do you feel that you're a leader right now? And tell us, why do you feel that you're a good leader?
I feel I'm a good leader because I know the takes to try to get to the next level and try to help other people get to the next level
mm-hmm.
because I'm still going through the process. So mm-hmm. I can help the people who hasn't been there mm-hmm. and learn from the people who has been there
mm-hmm.
in the situation I'm in. So I can give reference back to the people who wants to go where I'm going.
Okay. Now we'll say that's on the field. Now let's talk about your leadership off the field. Would you say that you're a good leader off of the field?
Yes, sir.
So expound upon that on what's your leadership like with your peers and your classmates. How do you feel that you're a good leader in that way?
In the class, I try to help other people. I try to go around the classroom, help the teaching, just
mm-hmm.
help other students learn some things that's difficult for them to learn or the mm-hmm. easy way that I learned it. But mm-hmm. outside of school, I try to help people, push them to do what they want to do and just never give up and just believe in God. You can do whatever is possible.
That's good. That's good. And I hear that you're a pretty good student yourself.
Yes, sir.
And you're taking pre-calculus now? Is that
yes,
what
sir.
I mean, how do you... I stopped at algebra 2. So what kind of math did you take last year?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure what no, it was, sir. But you know it was high up there on the list.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Terry, let me ask you this. Do you feel that you are the type of person that can make other people better around you? Do you really feel that?
Yes, sir.
Now, what qualities do you have that you feel that can rally your classmates, your teammates? What are some other qualities you have that make people better around you?
It's just my personality. My personality, it brings out the greatness inside a person. It just mm-hmm. brings out their funny side and just sometimes just get to know people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, say if it's a quiet student in the classroom sitting over there alone,
mm-hmm.
I go over there and talk to them, try to bring them around my friends that I hang with and try mm-hmm. to get them to talk and just not be so lonely.
Not be so lonely.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
All right. That's good. That's good. So, you also participated in called a Nike tour?
Yes, sir.
In Oregon. Now, explain to our viewers and listening audience, how did you get the invitation to go to this camp in Oregon?
I went to the Spark Combine for Nike, and that invited me to the NFTC camp.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, I did great there, so it kept inviting me until finally I got an invitation to the camp where you get invited to the opening
mm-hmm.
to go to Oregon.
Mm-hmm.
And I went there and I just did what God blessed me to do,
mm-hmm.
and I won MVP and they invited me.
So you won MVP?
Yes, sir.
Now, how many people actually got invited to Oregon?
I would say around about maybe 100 or 200.
100 or 200?
Yes, sir.
Man, wow, God has some incredible favor on your life. I know we talked about how, you know, you're good in football, you're good in basketball, baseball, or whatnot. We know a lot of your strengths in football.
Yes,
you play both ways, both sides of the ball, and we know you have a lot of strengths. So, what are some of your weaknesses in football? And as great as you are, I know all players have some type of weaknesses. What do you think some things that you need to improve on?
I would have to say speed and maybe my athleticism.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very athletic, but I think I can really improve on being more athletic than the normal average guy.
Mm-hmm.
And speed-wise, Everybody says I'm fast on the field, but to myself, I don't feel as fast. So mm-hmm. I feel like I can get faster and faster as mm-hmm. I grow up. Mm-hmm.
So what do you clock in the 40?
The fastest I've clocked is a 4.47.
4.47?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Terry, if you can go back, and I know I'm probably asking you some stuff, because all this is probably, it's kind of like a blur. It's happened so fast. You know, you've come up on, I don't know if you call it depth charts or whatnot in high school football, but as far as you doing the Nike tour, what are some other things? Did you participate in a lot of camps, other camps, when you were coming up early on in life? Did you participate in a lot of camps?
Yes, sir.
What are some other camps that you?
I would have to say the Under Armour Rivals camp. I went there and just did what God blessed me to do, and mm-hmm. They invited me to some more, and then I finally got invited to the 5-star challenge in Baltimore, and they flew me out to Baltimore while all the 5-stars out having the competition.
So you've been flown to a lot of these places.
Yes, sir.
So you've flown to Baltimore, you've flown to Oregon. What are some other places you've flown to participate in football?
Over the summer, I flew down to Florida with Cam Newton for his 7-on-7 team.
Mm-hmm. And are there any others? Man, what's that, man? I mean, people in high school in 11th, 12th grade year, you know, they're thinking about schoolwork.
Yes, sir.
You know, maybe a girlfriend, a boyfriend. and you get an opportunity to fly around the country to showcase your talent. What does that, has that really sunk in to
no,
you?
No, sir, not yet.
Not yet?
No, sir.
So how do you handle that, man?
Well, I don't handle it. I just let my mom handle it. She handle all my business.
So your mom we're talking backstage, is a very important person. So she handles everything.
Yes, sir.
But I can't even fathom what that would be like. You know, peer pressure and just dealing with the things that teenagers go through. And it seems like you're so busy with school and athletics, you really don't have a chance to even think about that. But that must be pretty awesome, man. So
yes,
so you don't feel like you're the man?
No, sir.
Okay, all right. Well, Terry, we're going to pause and take a quick commercial break. And when we come back, we're going to be talking about more on how you have been elevating throughout your football career. More Terry Godwin when we come back from the commercial break. You have pain, we have solutions. Total Healthcare of LaGrange Joint Restoration Program specializes in providing electrical stimulation and injections to get rid of your knee and shoulder pain. Total Healthcare's injections helps and repair ligaments, taking away all of your knee pain within 5 to 7 weeks. We offer special braces and supports to assist you, and we are now accepting Medicare with payment plans as low as $20 per month. If your joints need lubricating and you desire to regain mobility of your knee free of pain, Total Healthcare can make you new all over again.
Life in the country is a conscious choice. And with that choice comes hard work, attention to detail, and investing in the right tools to keep your home or farm at its best. So why choose anything but the very best zero turns on the market today? Exmark. Known for their durability, precision cut, and time-saving performance, Exmarks are the preferred brand of mowing equipment for the landscape professional and people like you who take pride in their lawn. For special pricing incentives, visit Exmark.com or your local dealer.
It's the 500 Truck Challenge at the Truck Supercenter for the entire Southeast. The all-new Opelika Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram and Opelika Ford. 500 trucks at the guaranteed lowest prices. Find the lower advertised price and we'll beat it by at least $500. Plus, we'll donate to ALS for every vehicle sold. New trucks, $10,000 off at the 500 Truck Challenge.
Folks, you've just got to see this place.
The all-new Opelika Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram and Opelika Ford. Just 25 minutes from Columbus.
Welcome back to the Kevin Dunn Show, where we are talking with a high school 5-star football recruit. Not only that, one of the top 5 recruits in the nation. And just in case you don't really know what that means, if we had a bunch of cars out here, Terry would be a Bentley, a Rolls Royce. If you had Lexuses and Infinities, you would actually be a Bentley or a Rolls Royce. Let's talk about a little bit more about how do you handle this? How do you keep your head from swelling, man? Because I know a lot of people would be in your position. You know, yes, I can imagine, you know, walking around school. You know, I'm the man. You know, everybody want me. So how do you handle that? How do you deal with that and keeping your, I know you said it hasn't sunk in yet, but what are some other ways that you handle that?
I treat it like every other day I go to school. Mm-hmm. Everything's the same. I have all the same friends. It's just, you're moving up in life. You're coming mm-hmm. to bigger and better things. So you just have to keep that aside and just not get too much feeling of yourself and just think you're highly over this guy or highly over this guy. Everyone's the same. You just have a God's ability. He's mm-hmm. very blessed. You're very blessed mm-hmm. to get the talent that you've gotten. So I just take advantage of it.
Okay, that's good. Now tell us some of the schools that have recruited you. I know we probably take about 2 hours, but if you can just give us about 10 schools who are actually recruiting you, who haven't stopped recruiting you, even though you committed to the University of Georgia, tell us some schools who are trying to get you to come to play football at their colleges.
I would say the University of Georgia, mm-hmm. Auburn, Alabama, Notre Dame, University of Southern California, South Carolina, Tennessee, and I would say North Carolina and Clemson.
And Clemson.
Yes, sir.
So those are all big time schools. Now, are any of the coaches telling you, and I'm pretty sure they tell all the recruits, that if you come play with us, you have the potential to start. Are you hearing
yes,
that a lot?
Yes, sir.
Is that a big deal to you to be able to walk into the institution and start, or do you think you need to get some more growth up under you before you play big time college football?
I think you should get more growth, but I think the point of starting, it's mm-hmm. all up to you and how you produce and practice. It's all what you're capable of doing and what you're showing the coaches.
Okay. And I've seen you on the internet. I've seen you other articles, Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Do people actually sponsor you to go? Are these tours actually sponsor for you to go to these camps and stuff like that?
Yes, sir.
Now, once again, you're on television, man. You're on the internet now, and how do you handle that, man? I mean, I know I'm just amazed that the calmness and the humility that you've shown ever since I've seen you a few times, but
yes,
you really act like it's not a big deal. If it does become a big deal and your head starts to swell, have you thought about what you're gonna do to maybe bring you back down to earth?
Just sit down and have a conversation with my parents. Mm-hmm. They always bring me back down to earth and just mm-hmm. tell me without God, nothing's possible. Mm-hmm. So just thank Him and just be blessed.
Thank Him and be blessed.
Yes, sir.
And now, as far as your peers and other people around you, your classmates, we'll talk about your classmates then, your teammates. How does your classmates handle the attention that you're getting? Because I know they see I don't know if Nick Saban has been down to the school to talk with you or Kirby Smart, anybody, but when they see you getting all this attention, how do your classmates handle that?
They handle it like a fan. I mean, most of them do, mm-hmm. but the ones that I just really have really friends, they treat it just like me. They're not just, well, that's Kirby Smart or that's Mark Reed. They're just like, oh, he's a coach. Maybe I should do what I have to do for mm-hmm. that to be me one year. Mm-hmm. I mean, I just try to teach them the things I've been taught and just how to get to the next level.
How to get to the next level. All right. Now, what about your teammates? Now, these guys, they go to war with you every day during the football season. So how does your teammates handle your attention?
I mean, they love it because any coach comes to me, they come out and watch practice. They uh-huh. try to show what they're capable of.
Okay.
And just hopefully they get an offer. I mean, they love it.
They love it.
Yes, sir.
Now tell us, I know you mentioned Rick and Smart. Name some other coaches that have been down to the school to watch you.
Coach Rick, Coach Kirby Smart, Coach Malzahn, Coach Craig, and Coach Reed for Clemson. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's been a lot of coaches.
Mm-hmm. A lot of coaches.
Yes, sir.
Coming down to see Terry Godwin.
Yes, sir.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Now, tell us about, now, I'm not going to say a lot. I know a few people who have been 5-star recruits who were getting a lot of attention. ESPN came down to the school and recorded where they announced that they were going to play college football. And some of them have kind of veered off and didn't follow that path of excelling. So what do you have in place to keep you focused to go where you have the potential to go? So what are some things you're going to be putting in place where you don't get caught up? You don't get caught up in the college life that can turn your focus in the wrong direction. What are you going to do to keep yourself in the place you need to be?
First, I'm going to keep God first. Mm-hmm. And then after that, I'm going to have a schedule of what all mm-hmm. I have to do throughout the week. And on the weekends, I'm going to go to church and just keep practicing and just keep my heart where it's supposed to be and just keep God first and keep thanking Him.
And keep thanking Him. Because, yes, you know, it's very easy for that to happen. You know, to get down in the college life, seeing the nice girls, nice attention, people catering to you.
Yes,
and I imagine for a lot of people, you know, that can be very difficult to deal with. So, you know, and we wonder, why do you think, in your opinion, and I'm not going to call any names, and you know players who messed up their opportunity. What do you think some things that they did wrong that kept them, and some of them end up not even being on the team anymore? You know, so what are some things you think that they did wrong?
I think that when they first got to college, they thought it was going to be like high school. You can go down there and have fun, just do what you want.
Mm-hmm.
But when you get to the next level, it's really all about business.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to go down there and do what you have to do and provide for your team. If mm-hmm. you're not providing, you're going to get benched or either you're going to be consequences. And all the going out, partying and all that, those have consequences too. Mm-hmm. You come to practice, you're tired, loafing around.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the coaches see that and it causes consequences. You have to take the consequences that you do.
Now, you said you're going to have a schedule.
Yes, sir.
Is that something that you're going to make out yourself?
Yes, sir.
So tell me, what is that something mom taught you?
yes, because she has a schedule for me for everything I do this week, next week, and the following week, so
uh-huh.
it's just something I grew up doing.
And that's good to have an organized chart, and that helps you to stay on task, so I applaud. And talking to the mom backstage, mom does not play. Mom does not play. But and you say your dad and your mom played sports in high school.
Yes, sir.
And both of them were pretty good at what they did.
Yes, sir.
Okay, another question I'm gonna ask you, you have a lot of Georgia fans nervous, because you are still taking your recruiting trips. Auburn, you've been to Georgia, you've been to Alabama, you have some other invites around the country. So what would you say to the Georgia fans who are nervous about you going to visit these other schools?
I would say do not be nervous, because this is a once in a lifetime chance I get to do to go around the world and visit mm-hmm. D1 colleges and just have fun. Mm-hmm. So I'm still 100% committed to Georgia. Don't be nervous.
You're still 100% committed to Georgia?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. It's very interesting you say that, because we know, you know, things can change, but he's just assured you guys that he's committed to Georgia, which I'm pretty sure that they, where are they recruiting you? Where would they like for you to, what position would they like for you to play?
My freshman year, they told me I'm going to play wide receiver, and then in my sophomore year, to get fundamental with the playbook, I'm going to play wide receiver, defense, and special teams.
And is that pretty much what all the colleges are somewhat telling you?
Yes, sir.
So you are an all-purpose player, but they plan on using you on offense and defense. Are you going to return any? Has anybody told you that they would like you to return any punts, any kickoffs?
Yes, sir.
What's your favorite position?
I have to say all of them.
All of them.
I just like being in places where I can make dynamic plays and just being the player that I am.
Have you ever played quarterback before?
Yes, sir.
So how often do you get to do that? Are you just mainly in the Wildcat, or how often do you get to play quarterback?
It's very seldom, but when I do, I get back there, I either have to hand it off, or I'm being a decoy by handing it off, then throwing a quick pass to one of the receivers or the tight ends
mm-hmm.
just to get them involved in the game.
And I saw the game when you guys played LaGrange, and it seemed like the game was just, you know, moving along kind of slow.
Yes,
and then
sir.
it just seemed like you elevated and you took control. I know a kickoff return, and you That was you that stiffed arm somebody pretty bad over there. Yes, I saw that from a distance. So what was that? The guy actually got upset with you too, didn't he?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, you hit him pretty hard, man. So did they call a penalty on you for that?
No, sir.
Okay, that was kind of rough, man. I don't know where you got that from. But okay, at the end of the day, whatever institution, I'm sorry, Georgia fans, when he signs with Georgia, at the end of the day, when Georgia gets a Terry Godwin, what are they getting besides a dynamic athlete?
Well, first and foremost, they getting a guy that believes in God and puts everything through Christ. Mm-hmm. And secondly, they getting a great guy with a great personality, someone who's going to work hard in practice and give it his all. No matter what, he's going to give it 120% more than the next guy because he has something that he has to do, and he has a challenge to overcome. He has different obstacles mm-hmm. to get over mm-hmm. and just do the things he loves.
Okay. And, you know, of course, wherever you go, everything is not going to always be peachy. Everything is not going to always be good. So how would you handle criticism where somebody you felt like, okay, well, I've given my best, but somebody would say, man, Terry didn't play his best game. He looked like he didn't give it his all. He dropped a few balls. He had a couple of fumbles. How would you handle that criticism?
Handling criticism, I just get on my knees every night and just pray and thank God for giving me the ability. No matter where the fans think or someone else, as long as I know I give my 120% every game, it's just that's all I need to know.
That's all you need to know.
Yes,
all right.
Sir.
Well, Terry Godwin, you're Terry Godwin Jr. too.
No, yes, sir.
That's your dad. You're Junior.
Yes, sir. I'm
Lil
Junior.
T, that's what they call you.
Yes,
well,
sir.
You're not really Lil. But anyway, man, we thank you so much for taking the time out to be a guest on the Kevin Dunn Show. Once again, Terry Godwin's a 5-star recruit, one of the top 5 high school players in the country. And we thank you so much, man. Wish you much success. Wish you a great season for the rest of your high school football career. And we appreciate you coming by and talking with us, man.
Yes, sir. No problem.
All right. And as always, if you have a topic that you would like to see discussed on the Kevin Dunn Show, please email us at thekevindunnshow@wjcntv.com. Thank you for watching. Hope you have a wonderful day. Yeah.